Hi guys, what's up? This is a series of Vesta CP or Vesta videos. It is a free, open source and very good alternative of cPanel. You can say it is a total package of wave hosting control panel. It includes spam assassin, which is email spam filter, ClamAV, which is email antivirus scanner, DNS, FTP, Subtaculous, which is the extra software package for the Vesta CP. And let's encrypt SSL certificate provider for websites. In this series of videos, I will guide you to install and configure the default Vesta CP components, upgrade the PHP and Roundcube version, create a force redirect HTTPS template for the website. Let's start. I have already created the VPS or droplet in a very popular cloud hosting provider. And this is my public IP address. I have accessed the VPS or droplet using this public IP address via the PuTTY. Here you can see the second lines. This is PHP common extensions. I will install this common PHP common extension while upgrading the PHP version. So first of all, go to your browser and browse the vestacp.com and go to install tab. These are the operating systems supported by Vesta CP or Vesta. My operating system is Ubuntu. Here, these are the components you need to select to install. So for the wave, you can choose various options: Nginx plus Apache, Nginx plus PHP, FVM, Apache only, but I will continue with Nginx plus Apache. With this configuration, Apache will be the backend web server and Nginx will be the frontend web server. So this is the FTP service provider. There is two options. If you don't want to use the FTP, you can select no, but I think the FTP service is required or very useful on later on, so you need to select one. I will continue with default VS FTPD and mail server. For the mail server, you can select no. It means there will be no mail server in Vesta CP. If you select the EXIM, you will have the mail server, but you will not have IMAP and POP email server. So for that, you need to select the Dovecat. If you select Dovecat plus ClamAV, there will be antivirus for the email server. If you select EXIM plus Dovecat plus spam assassin, you will have the spam filter in your email server. If you select the EXIM plus Dovecat plus spam assassin plus ClamAV, you will have all the components like email server, POP IMAP server, spam filter and antivirus for email server. So I will continue with a full component. DNS, if you don't want to host the DNS server, you can select no, but it will be better to select the one DNS server which is named, and Vesta will install the bind 9. Firewall, IP tables and filter ban, or IP tables only or no. It is better to select both because of IP tables is firewall and filter ban is brute force monitor. Subtaculous, no or yes. I recommend to select yes because of Subtaculous is the software package provider. You can select or install lots of software package in Vesta CP later on. There are some of paid software and some of are free. You can choose or select the free or paid depending on your requirement. And additional repository REMI, this is fine. A file system quota, you should select yes because of if you are planning to create the medium size or you want to run your own web hosting company or provider, you need to create the file system quota, so it will be better to select yes. And database, VestaCP supports two types of database, PostgreSQL and MySQL. I will continue with MySQL. So hostname, my hostname is here in Google DNS. I have one public domain. This is myadmin.com DNS. There is nothing until now. So here hostname is sysmyadmin.com, email address and password. Select your password. So this is my demo. I will select normal password. Okay, rooted.admin. Generate command. VestaCP installation command is generated. Before that, we need to create two E record in DNS server using this public IP address here. At the rate, it means public domain name. Record type is A, and default TTL time is 1 hour. It is good, but while making this video, I cannot wait 1 hour, so I will provide the 90 seconds. It means 1.5 minute. Okay, this is public IP address, add and create another one, which is www. www is required by, let's encrypt certificate. So time is same, 90 seconds, and this is public IP address, add. In meantime, copy this command, and okay, before that, update your system or virtual machine or droplet. For that, apt update. Okay, one more thing, if you are logged in using the admin account but not root account, you have to run sudo command. I am using the root account, so I don't need to run sudo command. Sudo, so just command only. Apt update, hit enter. Okay, now copy this command and paste here. Okay, after that, copy all this command and paste here and hit enter. These are the components we have selected while creating the installation command. If you have changed the mind or you want to change the component, you can go back here, change your components, and it will generate again. After that, verify your settings and hit yes and enter. It will take 15 minutes. It depends on your system resources like RAM, a core of CPU, hard drive types. In 15 minutes, installation will be finished. Okay, VestaCP installation is completed successfully. This is the URL. Let's browse it and see what is happening. This is self-signed certificate, that's why it says it is untrusted. That's fine, we will provide the verified certificate later on. Okay, this is the front page of VestaCP. Users, wave, DNS, mail server, database, account for the scheduler job, backup, packages. Yeah, everything is here. Server, these are the component we selected while creating the installation command. IP tables, file to bin, corn. Yeah, everything is here. We have just installed the default VestaCP or Vesta control panel. First of all, let's talk about the security. This is the default port of VestaCP. It is always better to use different port than default port. So let's change the default port of this VestaCP. For that, go to firewall and create one rule. Exception is accept protocol TCP fine port define your custom port. For this demo, I am going to use 4040. That's fine. IP address. If you have static IP address, you can define your static IP. If you have dynamic IP, please don't provide here because of dynamic IP are not accessible after a few times. I'm going to assign 0.0.0/0. It means it will be accessible from all over the world, like from the internet, from anywhere. So comment Vesta CP. Okay, Vesta control panel. Add invalid comment. Okay, do not keep space or put space. Add. Go to back. Rule is created. Port is 4040, and rule is accept and from anywhere. So before changing the Vesta CP control panel default port, please create the firewall rule. Otherwise, you will not able to browse from the browser. Here, Nano. I am using Nano as a text editor. If you have gedit or vi, we can use one. User local Vesta nginx configuration directory conf and nginx.conf. This is nginx configuration file. Hit enter and look for the listen parameter or line. Here it is. Listen. Change it to the custom port, which is 4040 in our case. Control O for the write, hit enter and exit. Control X for the exit. Now service nginx restart. We have made some changes in nginx config file. We need to restart the service and service Vesta restart. Okay, we have created two DNS records. Let's try those records too. So ping sysmyadmin.com, fine, and www.sysmyadmin.com. yeah, that's fine. Okay, now refresh this page. This page should not be open. Yeah, so now send the port here, 4040. Yeah, we have successfully sent the Vesta CP default port. Next step, go to WAV, and this is because of this is self-signed certificate, we'll issue the certificate from Let's Encrypt. Go to edit, click on edit, and IP address, please select the public IP address, and alias is www.sysmyadmin.com. that's fine. Web, there is no HTTPS, default is HTTP only. In next step, we will create the force HTTPS redirection template for the Apache and nginx. Because of there is no HTTPS or SSL template, for now we can issue the Let's Encrypt certificate for the website, but we need to browse manually. Save. Okay, changes have been saved. Back and it is Let's Encrypt here. It is not redirected to the HTTPS, it is HTTP. If we manually enter the HTTPS, it will work fine. Yeah, this is fine. It is HTTPS. More information. It is secure, verified by Let's Encrypt. But still, the connection is not secure, let's provide the same certificate, which is sysmyadmin.com certificate for the control panel. For that, go to server and select your domain, configure here Festa SSL, use web domain SSL certificate, domain is sysmyadmin.com. Click save. Yeah, now refresh your page. Yes, recent. Yeah, now this is Vesta control panel with this custom port and verified by Let's Encrypt here. That's fine. Okay, we just secure the Vesta control panel using different port than default port. Next step, let's provide the force HTTPS redirection template. So go to your server. My server has been restarted one time, so it is in default mode. That's okay. Before that, you access the Vesta CP control panel where it provides the forcefully a redirection of HTTPS template. So c.vestacp.com/0.9.8. I think this is the site. Yeah, this is the site. And my operating system is Ubuntu. Okay, here you can find the force HTTPS. That's great. And we need to download this HTTPS template, so I'm going to copy this one. Okay, the file name nginx.tr.gz, this one. We have just copied the download link. Go to your server and go to the web directory of website. So cd user local Vesta data templates web. Here we need to download this package wget. This is the download command and this is the file. Okay, file is downloaded. Tar xzvf. And package is nginx.tar.gz. Hit enter. Package is extracted. Let's see. Yeah, there is nginx. That's fine. Now I'm going to remove the downloaded package. So remove force nginx dot. Okay, that's good. Now service Vesta restart. Okay, now go to the Vesta control panel, select your site, click on edit. Here this is proxy template for nginx. Here force HTTPS. In next step, I'm going to create the same force HTTPS template for Apache 2. For that, go to your server again, back to one directory, up to templates, and go to Apache 2 directory. Okay, we need to go to the web. So cd user local Vesta data template. Yeah, this is the same directory. That's fine. And okay, one more directory, Apache 2. My internet is gone. I will back when I have the connectivity again. Now I have the internet access. Now go to the same directory, up to Apache directory. So cd user local data templates web and Apache 2. Apache 2. There is two files, default.stpl and default.tpl files. Copy both files to default.https. So copy default.tpl to default.https.tpl. Okay, and same again. Copy default.stpl to default.https.stpl. That's fine. List and let's see. Default.https, default.https.tpl and default.https.tpl file. Please keep in mind that if you have configured the Apache as backend and Nginx as frontend, you don't need to create the HTTPS template for Apache. So service Apache to restart and service Vesta restart. Okay, I'm going to close this tab. Okay, fine. Refresh page one more time. Okay, admin. And here default HTTPS. We need to add some line in default-https.tpl file to redirect HTTPS powerfully. So nano default https.tpl. In this configuration, we don't need to do any modification in .stpl file. We need to do some modification in .tpl file only, which is default-https.tpl file. Hit enter. Before the virtual host closing tag, add one line there. In this section, add one line. Redirect permanent space slash space https percentage domain underscore idn percentage and slash. Control O, it is right. Okay, hit enter to save and control X to exit. Service Apache 2 restart, service Vesta restart. That's fine. And we have already tested that there are two default HTTPS templates. So for the testing, I'm going to create a new subdomain. Subdomain, I will create new subdomain. So subdomain will be demo dot, this is my admin.com, and IP address will be this one, and TTL time again 90 seconds 8, and same www. Because of to issue the let's encrypt SSL certificate, we need a record and www a record. 90 seconds www.demo.demo. Okay, what is the dot? Now it is fine. Wait. Okay, wait for the 1.5 minute. Almost 1.5 minute is passed. Let's try. So ping demo.sysmyadmin.com. Yeah, close this one, and I'm going to create a new website. It says demo.sysmyadmin.com. Select your public IP address if you want to browse from the internet. DNS support, mail support, okay. Add, that's fine. Go to web again. Here, click on edit. That's fine. Here, default HTTPS. If the Apache is backend only, you don't need to select the HTTPS, you can select default. And proxy is force HTTPS, SSL support, and SSL certificate provider is let's encrypt, and home is public underscore HTML. If you want to provide the additional FTP account, you can create here. If you doesn't create the additional FTP account, you have to log in using the admin account. So save, since have been saved, created, back, and it says SSL support, let's encrypt. Okay, let's try to copy this one. I'm going to open the private window, HTTP. Now it should redirect to the HTTPS. Yeah, it is automatically redirected to the HTTPS. Okay, we have successfully created the force HTTPS redirection template. Next step, we will upgrade the PHP version in Vesta CP. First of all, we need to verify which is the PHP version we are using currently. So, okay, I'm going to the home directory or root directory. PHP version, it is 7.2. And another method, go to your website home directory. So cd home admin web demo dot, yeah, this one, and public dot html. Okay, and create one php info dot php file. Touch php info dot php, this file, nano php info dot php, and add few lines. So php php info bracket, open and close, semicolon, and close php, control write. Okay, exit service Apache 2, restart service Vesta, restart. Okay, now I'm going to browse the php info dot php, and it is php version 7.2. okay, again go to the server. I'm going to clear this one. Okay, now we need to install software common properties, and we need to add a pp repository of Android. Apt install software properties common. Okay, add apt repository ppa is, oh, it should be colon, yeah, unraised PHP. Enter. Now we need to update the PPA, so apt update. Before installing the PHP 7.4, let's check two things: webmail and database. Okay, this is database, PHP my admin, username admin, and you know the password. Oh, admin default, admin underscore default. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, I don't know the password, so save. Now try to log in. It is logged in, that's fine. And for that, round cube. Admin, and the user account is admin@sysmyadmin.com. So same password created. Now open, it will redirect to the webmail here. Successfully logged in. There will be some problem in resetting password, so I am going to reset the password. Oh, it says could not save new password. It cannot save the new password because of we have changed the default port from the Vista control panel, but in Roundcube configuration file it is default or old one, so we need to change the port. So go back there. Before upgrading the PHP, we will fix the round cube issue, which is unable to save password. So go to cd etc round cube plugins password config, not cd, nano config.ink.php. here it is. It is still port is 8083, which is old one. We need to provide the new one. Control O is right, enter, Control X is exit, and another place, there is two place to change the round cube configuration file. So nano user share round cube plugins after the password and vesta.php. okay, after that drivers and vesta.php. yeah, here please do not change the server host, which is localhost. Leave it to localhost, that's fine. Here 4040, control right, exit, service vesta restart. Okay, now go to the web mileage here. Refresh the page, resend. Oh, it is a successful chain. Okay, one more time. Yes, we just fixed the password saving issue in round cube. Okay, finally, let's upgrade the PHP 7.4. So apt install PHP 7.4. Yes, please. Okay, PHP 7.4 is installed, and we need to install some common extension of PHP. Copy apt install hit enter. Yes, okay, PHP is installed successfully. Let's check the PHP version. Yeah, this is 7.4.7, and here php.info, php.info.php, but it still says it is 7.2. So to fix this issue, go back to server, Apache 2, this mode, PHP 7.2, hit enter, and Apache 2, enable mode, PHP 7.4, enter, and systemctl restart Apache 2, hit enter, Apache 2 is restarted. Now we will check, yeah, it is PHP 7.4. That's great. Before uninstalling the PHP 7.2, let's verify some settings, like rebrowse the PHP MyAdmin, looks fine. Okay, looks fine. The file upload size is maximum is 2048 KB, so next step we will increase the max file upload size. And round cube, let's change the password again, because of this is the main issue in round cube, if you have made any changes. Okay, that's successful. Mail compose, yeah, and it is 5 MB maximum allowed file size is 5 MB. In next step, not next, after increasing the PHP MyAdmin file upload size or database upload size, we will fix the email file upload size in RoundCube. So I think everything is good. I'm going to uninstall the PHP 7.2. So apt remove PHP 7.2 ESTIC if there is anything after PHP 7.2. It means remove PHP 7.2 with is all extensions. Hit enter. S. Okay, PHP 7.2 is uninstalled successfully. Apt auto remove. Okay, everything looks fine. I'm going to reboot the system to make sure that everything is fine. Okay, it is rebooted and connected, and it is great. It is browsing, everything should be fine now. Yeah, that's fine. For the PHP, my admin to configure the database upload size. I think we can configure from here. I'm not sure, but let's see. So Apache 2 configure, because of we need to configure the PHP.ini from here. Execution time, memory limit, that's fine. Okay, 8.2. So for it, let's try to change this one. I'm good with 20. 20 should be fine. Save. Save. Changes have been saved. Let's refresh this one. Ignore 20 bytes. M. Save. Yeah, now it is 20 MB. There is three options. First option is here. The second option is go to advanced options and find the same parameters. I'm going to find that one. Find max underscore. Okay, not this one. Execution time. Okay, yeah. It changed here 20. If you doesn't find the GUI option, you can change from here. You need to change in two lines. One line is first line is this one, post max size is 20 m, upload max size 20 m. That's fine. And third is by editing the PHP.ini file from the server. For that, go to nano etc PHP, and now our version is 7.4. After that, Apache and PHP.ini file. Okay, here also you need to find what is happening. Now it's fine. Not this one, not this one. Nope, 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 nope. Okay, this there is post max size 20 m, and again upload max file size 20 m. That's fine, but it is still 5 MB. So go back to server. Nano etc round cube and stxs here. Okay, upload file max file size 20 MB. This one is also. Keep post max size is one number higher than upload max file size. Ctrl O X. Refresh the page. Yeah, it is 20 MB. Change to 20 MB. Next step is upgrade this round cube version, because of for now it is 1.3.6. The new version is 1.4.7. So let's upgrade the round cube version. Before that, I'm going to create few emails to verify that after the upgrading we didn't lose any database or datas. So compose, I will send email to myself. Test email send. Send to myself and send. Okay, I am going to reply to myself again. Reply all. Got it. Yeah, two emails in inbox and two emails in sent item. Okay, after the upgrading, these four emails inbox and sent item we accessed. And before that, go to servers. In exim configure and spam score, please lower down it to 10 to 5. So I'm going to the 10 because of if you leave it default, which is 50, you will not be able to receive the email from Gmail or Hotmail because of it is very high for the spam score. 10 is fine. If you have any issue, you can go up to 5. Please do not go below the 5. Don't keep just this 5. If you want to keep it 5, then 5.0. For me, it is 10 is fine. And for your email reputation and delivery, go to DNS, and there are lots of records. You need to assign these records to your DNS. Domain key, this one. DMARC, this one. ESPF record, this one. And this is DKIM. And EMX record. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 records, you need to create on your DNS record. For that, this is DKIM. And the record type is text. For the example, click on edit. Record name is this one. Okay, type is text record. 1 hour is fine. And copy this one, and this is the value. Yeah, this one. Edit and wait for 1 hour. After providing the all records, DMARC, DKIM, and ESPF record, your email reputation will be high. Otherwise, you will not able to send emails to Gmail or Hotmail or like this type of public domains. So, please don't forget to make the records in your DNS server. Okay, now time to upgrade RoundCube. So, go back to your server. First step to upgrade the RoundCube, take backup of your old RoundCube configuration file. So cd var library lib RoundCube to var lib library in same directory but RoundCube dot backup. Hit enter. Sorry, not cd, move, mb move. Yeah, hit enter. Okay, cd var library, there should be two file now, roundcube and roundcube.bak. yeah, there it is, roundcube.backup file. And next step, we need to download the updated version of RoundCube. So, okay, here, https github.com RoundCube mail. After that, we need this complete one. Copy link location, is this correct? Yeah, this is the correct one. So here, wget, hit enter. Yeah, it is downloaded. Now we need to extract the RoundCube mail compressed file. So tar exzvf RoundCube, yeah, this one, hit enter. Let's see the, yeah, this is extracted, that's fine. Rename or move this RoundCube mail, this 1.4.7 to the default name, which is RoundCube only. So mb move round cube male, yeah, this one to round cube list. It is moved this round cube to same directory. Now we need to fix some permission issue. So change owner recursive www data w data, this is the group, to where far library round cube and temp, hit enter. Okay, that's fine. Now next step, we need to rename the config.ink.php sample file to config.ink.php. For that we need to go to the round cube and config directory. Okay, there is config.ink.php.sample file, this file to config.ink.php file. So move mv config.ink.php.sample to config.ink.php. Okay, yeah, that's fine, clear. We need to restart the services. So service Apache, this is the backend, so we need to restart the Apache to service. Restart, good. Next step, we need to find the database name, database password, like host name, port, everything. So cat etc round cube jbn.db.php, here it is, db username, db password, db name, db server, and port, database type is MySQL. We need to write down somewhere this db username, password, and database type. So here, we need to provide this database username, password, database name, database server name to round cube configuration file. So nano config.ink.php in this file. So here in this line, user colon password at the rate server name and round cube mail. Okay, so this should be db username, db pass, db server, and db name. So what is our, it is db user round cube, that's fine. Password is this one and db name is round cube. Okay, let's make some changes. Okay, and delete the mail section because of database name is round cube only. Yeah, control O, write out, enter, save, exit, control X, exit. Service Apache 2, because of this is PHP file, so Apache 2 service needs to be restarted. Restart, fine. And next command, we need to hold the automatic update from repository. So apt mark hold round cube. Okay, round cube set on hold, so it will not get any automatic updates from the Ubuntu repository. Now go back to the webmail, here it is. Okay, admin at the rate sysmyadmin.com, what was the password when I send it? Yeah, this is the password, and here it is. I have both mail in inbox. Where is the sent item? Okay, here is the sent item. Yeah, both email in sent item also. And check the version. Yeah, Roundquip webmail 1.4.7. Okay, finally we have upgraded Roundquip version to 1.4.7 in Festa. We have also upgraded the PHP version 7.4.7 in Vesta, and we have successfully uninstalled the 7.2, which is older version, and we have successfully increased the SQL file size upload in through the PHP MyAdmin, and we have also increased the email attachment file size in Roundquip. Let's check in upgraded Roundquip. Compose. Yeah, it is 20 MB. Okay, everything is fine. Everything is running. And graphs. Yeah. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel. If you have any questions regarding this Vesta CP or Vesta configuration, please let me know in comment section. Thank you.